from civil rights leaders to leaders in science. Stay tuned to number one to find out the most important women in history. Number 10, Henrietta Lacks. A sad truth about the nature of our world is that sometimes a man or woman makes a great sacrifice or pledge towards the benefit of the world or humanity, and they don't get credit for it. For the woman known as Henrietta Lacks, her pledge toward the world was her very own cells, and they helped change the way we look at medicine. But for the longest time, her family, and even herself, before she passed away, didn't know the contribution that she made. Lacks was ill one day with a pain in her abdomen, and so she went to John Hopkins Hospital near Roanoke, Virginia, where she was diagnosed with a type of cancer on her cervix. Ironically, this was actually a misdiagnosis, as she really had a different kind of cancer altogether. When a cell culture was taken to be examined, the doctors found that her cells were immortal, in the sense that they not only couldn't die, but also that they continued to replicate infinitely. Her cells were stolen, replicated, and spread out all over the world so that more people could research them and see what medical advances could be made by this discovery. And many advances were indeed made, including the cure for polio, the birth of chemotherapy treatments, and the mapping of the human gene, and more. The Lacks family eventually found out what the doctors had done to Henrietta and are still fighting for her and the family to get the credit she truly deserves. Though not official, many do call her the mother of modern medicine because of everything that her cells have done. Number 9. Susan B. Anthony. In the United States and much of the world today, there are pretty much equal rights for both men and women. Both have the right to vote, to run for office, to have a business, to do everything that the other gender can do. But in the early days of the United States, women were relegated to homekeeper roles. They were mainly only allowed to do the housework, while the men were the breadwinners. But as time went on, women wanted to do more, including having the right to vote and help choose who gets put into office. This was the birth of the suffrage movement, and the biggest organizer of that movement was Susan B. Anthony. And to be clear, Anthony didn't do this for just a year, or two, or five. She helped lead the suffrage movement for 50 years. And even risked getting arrested at times because her ideas were deemed offensive, clearly offensive to men. Anthony helped co-found the American Equal Rights Association, and she helped write its newspapers too. She went around the country organizing events, rallying women to the cause, and helping prove why women deserved the right to vote. Finally, in 1920, women got that right to vote, and Susan B. Anthony got her face on the silver dollar for her contributions to the cause. Number 8. Alice Coachman. Before we talk about this amazing woman, take a moment to like this video and join the Zero to Hero community by using the buttons below. Another sad part about United States history was that in the 19th century, it was believed that white athletes, both male and female, were superior in every way. But in the 1930s and 1940s, that was shattered in multiple ways, as Jesse Owens went to the Berlin Games and beat the superior athletes from Germany and other countries to win multiple gold medals. Then, in the 1948 London Games, Alice Coachman won the gold medal in high jump to become the first African-American female to win a gold medal. She was personally awarded the medal by King George VI, and then was later praised at the White House by President Harry S. Truman. Her fame helped push black athletes in the US and even got her the first endorsement deal in African American history, male or female. If I had gone to the games and failed, there wouldn't be anyone to follow in my footsteps. It encouraged the rest of the women to work harder and fight harder, Coachman told the New York Times in 1996. Much like Owens before her, she set a standard for excellence and proved that color is not a qualification for athletic ability. Many African American athletes have followed in her footsteps, and they can all thank Coachman for making that possible. Number 7. Marie Curie. You may be surprised by just how many women helped find, or found, key elements that we take for granted today. One such woman is Marie Curie, who was a scientist who founded the entire field of radioactivity. In fact, she was the one that came up with the word radioactivity. So literally, that field belongs to her. Once she discovered it, she then expanded upon it and helped bring new innovations to the field, including several cures for cancer, and that was just the start of her achievements. Curie boasts an extraordinary array of achievements, says Patricia Farah, president for the British Society for the History of Science, who nominated the Polish-born French scientist. She was the first woman to win a Nobel Prize, first female professor at the University of Paris, and the first person, note the use of person there, not woman, to win a second Nobel Prize. Number 6. Harriet Tubman. When talking about the civil rights movement, it's easy to talk about those who worked above ground to try and fight for the rights of African Americans and those who were born into slavery or were slaves after the fact. But for Harriet Tubman, she just didn't want to say things. She wanted to do things. And she did. Tubman was born into slavery, but eventually she got out of her situation, but not before realizing that it was wrong to leave all those men, women, and children behind who were still slaves. So she created what is now famously known as the Underground Railroad. Over the course of a few months, Tubman helped guide over 70 slaves to safety, and even went the extra mile to help them find jobs and make a new life for themselves. As if that wasn't enough, when the Civil War came, she joined the Union Army as both a scout and a spy. Harriet Tubman didn't just talk the talk, she walked the walk. Number 5. Elizabeth I. When you think about the United Kingdom, or England as it's more commonly known, you think about a grand country that is steeped with history and famous figures. But there was a time when that wasn't real, but a fantasy. That is, until Elizabeth I came to power in England and helped truly change the landscape of the world. She was a smart leader and a brave one. England at the time was a very isolated country and low on the power spectrum. Through her tactics and her motivating the people, England rose up to become one of the greatest powers in the world, and the country has remained that way ever since. Her reign was so popular that the period is now known as the Elizabethan Age. And there was a movie or seven made about her. I'm just saying. Number 4. Margaret Hamilton. NASA has a very interesting history in the United States, but one thing that is sometimes lost in regards to the organization is that there have been many women who have helped make NASA what it is today. A great example of this is Margaret Hamilton, whose software was vital in terms of getting men to the moon. That moon. Hamilton was actually the leader of the software engineering division that was contracted by NASA to help make a navigational and guidance system for the Apollo 11 shuttle, and Hamilton worked very hard to make sure that it was everything it needed to be so that the astronauts could land on the moon safely. And they did. Later on in life, both NASA and the President of the United States honored Hamilton for her service to the program, and this led to many other women coming on board at NASA to help expand the program even more. Number 3. Ella Fitzgerald. The First Lady of Song, the Queen of Jazz, Lady Ella. There are many ways to describe Ella Fitzgerald, and legendary is definitely among them. She's considered one of the greatest singers of all time, especially in the genre of jazz, and her accolades and awards are far-reaching because of it, not the least of which is 12 Grammy Awards. For over 60 years, Ella Fitzgerald sang her heart out for anyone who would listen, and that's why the world at large fell in love with her. And though she passed away at the age of 79, her music is still being remembered and played to this day. Oh, and she also got the Presidential Medal of Freedom, which is the highest award that a civilian can get from the government. You have to be pretty special to earn that. And Ella Fitzgerald was indeed very special. Number 2. Eleanor Roosevelt. When it comes to the title of First Lady, most consider it an honorary position, something that wields no true power. While that may have been true for some, Eleanor Roosevelt is the one that helped make it much more than that. This was a woman who was almost literally the right hand of her husband, the four-time president Franklin Delano Roosevelt. In fact, many consider her the reason that the First Lady position at the White House is more prominent now than it was before her, because she was never afraid to make her voice and opinion heard. She fought for equal rights for all citizens, as well as human rights in general. She was the first spouse in presidential history to hold her own press conferences, and that was just the start of it all. She also wrote news columns and even hosted a radio show. And back then, radio shows were very important to the people, so for her to have one was a big deal. Some even say that when Franklin Delano Roosevelt was severely ill via his polio bout, Eleanor took over the role of president, which technically means she was the first female president of the United States, depending on how you look at it. Even with the passing of her husband in 1945, she continued to serve as a political leader, From 1945 to 1952, she was the American delegate at the United Nations General Assembly, and helped many more assemblies for many years to come. So when you think of the title First Lady, Eleanor Roosevelt should be the one that instantly pops into your mind. Number 1. Eve. Surprised? Well, if you think about it, whether you believe in the Christian religion or not, you have to acknowledge that once upon a time, there was a first female. And because of the popular Bible story, we now refer to that first female as Eve. If history has taught us anything, it's that there's always a first. And Eve may just be the first female human ever. And so without her, the whole human race wouldn't be what it is now. Even science acknowledges the story of the Garden of Eden by having the first female of a new species be referred to as its Eve. So when religion and science both acknowledge something, you know it's important. What's that? Eve doomed the world by biting the apple Satan gave her? Details. Minor details. What do you think about these amazing women? Let us know in the comments below and take care.